Hola Queens, it's your girl Queen T here, also known as the one and only fiance coach. If you're new to my YouTube channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button. If you're tuning in on your favorite podcast platform, welcome, welcome, welcome. I hope that you find that this is a safe space for you and that you return back every week for a new episode of the Fiance Diaries podcast. I am the one and only fiance coach, also known as Queen T. This is my channel, and I'm happy that you could join us. Today, we're going to be talking about a really juicy topic. It might be a little extended, but I really feel like I should not put this off much longer. In last week's episode of the S Word Part 1, I said that this might be two or three parts, and I really feel like let's just go ahead and give you the rest of this because we cannot continue to prolong this. This is a topic that gets talked about and touched on so lightly that I felt like let's just jump into it because you get the light hand weight of it and it just doesn't serve you well. So hopefully these practical tips that I'm going to give you in the S Word Part 2, that's what this is going to help you walk away and feeling like you've learned a bit more about submission and how you can actually apply it to your life. Again, last week I shared theoretical tips. This week I'm sharing practical tips, and these are tips not only that I just pulled out of my head. I promise you, I've been meditating, I've been praying, and these tips were not only just provided to me by God himself, but they are actual tips that I've been practicing and living. I'm not going to say that I'm perfect at them. Last week I talked about you never fully arrive at submission. It's something that you practice at daily. So these are practical tips that I hope you ladies will also learn to practice daily. We'll be in this walk together. I love to keep it transparent. There will be some tips you'll see me a little shaky on. That should automatically just tell you that, this is something Queen T struggled with. Let me pray for her. That's what you should say, sis. That's what you should say. Pray for Queen T, all right? Because Queen T praying for you. All right, girl. So let's get back to this. Because it's a lot, I'm just going to jump into it. I do have a notebook here, so I hope that you ladies also have a notebook, a journal, a diary, whatever you keep close, and a pen. You might need a pencil because you might have to erase some stuff and go back, cross it out, put your initials next to it, let it be known that, girl, that's not what she meant. She really meant this. It's just a lot here, y'all. So I hope that y'all are able to relate to a lot of this stuff that I'm saying. And some of this stuff may kind of ruffle your feathers a bit, but that's good because that's letting you know that's an area in your life that you need to work on. All right, so the S Word Part 2, y'all, these are the practical tips. All right, number one, I have be a partner. It sounds so easy because you get married and you realize that, okay, I'm uniting with my kingdom partner. We're going to do God's kingdom work. But hold up, sis, slow down. It's not as easy as it sounds. Being a partner is difficult. Think about it. No matter how old you are, you've spent X amount of time by yourself taking care of yourself. There are some people that just got married after graduating high school. But think about it. You've only woken up in the morning and thought about yourself. Now you have to think about this totally, I was going to say stranger. See, that's horrible, y'all. That's horrible. This is something that Queen T struggles with. All right. You're waking up every day and then there's this person there. They're there every day, every day. You know, even when your breath stinks, even when you don't feel like looking cute, you know, they are there. You have to learn to be a partner. You have to learn to be one with them. And I say that because you have to change your I into we statements. I'm not saying lose your identity. You never want to lose your identity. All right. Hold on to your identity. We'll talk about that a bit later. But change your I into we statements. What do I mean by this? When you're talking about places you want to move, you know, financial investments you want to do, things like that, this is your partner. You should inquire with them about how they feel about these things. This is something that Queen T had to learn, y'all, and I'm still dealing with it, being a partner. Support his visions. Allow him to support your visions, you know? But know this, ladies, that may require a sacrifice. it may require you putting your goal or your vision on hold to enable his, or vice versa. It's a partnership. It goes both ways. It's not about, oh, I don't get to live my dreams, he gets to live his. Sometimes in a marriage, it's like a balance beam. It's like, babe, I'ma hold you up, you know, and when you get yourself together, babe, boom, I need us to, you know, switch it. You need to hold me up. Be a partner. Another thing about being a partner is, do not withhold serious information, y'all. I'm looking down at my notes if you're watching on YouTube. Do not withhold serious information. What is serious information? Stuff about your finances, stuff about your health, promotions, losses, failures, things like that. Depression, that just came to me. That's not in my notes. You need to open up about that, because that affects your partner. It's not just about you. And a lot of times we think that, oh, I didn't tell him because I didn't want him to worry about me, or I didn't want him to think it was a big deal. It is a big deal because you're his partner. Don't think for him how he's going to take it. You know, figure out with God the best way to talk to your spouse about it, but do not hold it as a secret. You're learning to be a partner. It's not just about you, all right? So that didn't come from me. That came from my prayer time. And that is also something that I'm working on that I'm not so great at. But every day I strive for it. And I notice some days that I'm really, really great at it. And I'm just like, oh, I can't wait to tell my hubby about this and get his opinion about it. All right. So that's number one, be a partner. Number two, keep your advice to yourself, queen. Keep your advice to yourself. What does this mean? Keeping your advice to yourself. Here's the exception though, unless he asks for it, all right? A lot of us ladies, we are know-it-alls. We believe that our way is the best way. We see ourselves as the helpmate, the secretary, you know, like the nurse to the doctor. And we see it as like, you can't even move the head without the neck, right? So we think that we have to give our opinion and our advice about everything. And I'm going to tell you to pump your brakes, sis. Pump your brakes. Keep your advice to yourself. What I want you to do is be supportive of his ideas and goals. All right. Be supportive. Say things like, babe, I think that's great. You know, ask questions, you know, seem intrigued and interested by it. Don't shoot him down. You may don't look at it as like your advice is shooting his viewpoint down, but it kind of is, sis. You know, it's kind of like you're saying that my idea might be better. I mean, let's not front, lady. Sometimes our ideas are better, but is this really the time and place to bring it up? So let's just think about that. Another thing is, it's better just to not throw your two cents in all the time, all right? No need to prove that you're smarter than your husband. He already knows you smart, sis. He already knows. That's why he chose you. That's why you got the rock on your hand and not the other ladies, okay? That's why he chose you. You don't have to prove to your bae that you smart. All right, queen? You don't have to prove that, all right? He already know. He already know he won when he got you, all right? He already know. And here's another one I had to learn. Sometimes, sis, he just want to vent. He just want to vent. And you want to know how I know this? Because I just want to vent sometimes, all right? And I know you just want to vent sometimes. And I think if at the beginning we just make this clear, I've started doing that where I just want to vent and I say to my husband like, hey babe, like I need to vent. Like, you know, I don't need no advice, you know, let him know. I just want to vent because I'm frustrated about something. You know, I just got to get it out of my system. There is nothing wrong with doing a preface, okay? You do what you gotta do. But this is about reversing it. Sometimes he just wanna vent. All right, let that man vent. Even if you don't agree with him, if you don't agree that he mad at his homeboy because of X, Y, and Z, it kind of sounds silly. Just be like, dang, babe, that's messed up. I'm sorry you had to deal with that. You know, take that to God later. If you feel like, God, he a little crazy. It wasn't that serious, in my opinion. Don't do that. Don't go back and forth with him about, you know, babe, you wrong about this. You wrong about that. No, be supportive. Be supportive. All right. Be supportive. If you feel like he wrong, bring it up at another time when he not upset anymore. All right. So that's numero dos. Keep your advice to yourself, sis. I added that sis part on there because it just seems so smooth. Number three, because we are already getting too into this. Don't match his aggression. All right. What do I mean by that? Men tend to be very aggressive when they are, when they're upset, you know, how they express themselves, they're more direct than we are. I'm not saying that women aren't direct, but it's not natural for us to be aggressive. It's not a part of our femininity. It's something that a lot of us have taken on because of maybe how we were raised. Maybe we were raised in like an independent woman household. Maybe we are in these jobs that require us to be alpha women. But I'm letting you know, in your marriage, do not match your husband's aggression with aggression. It's a masculine trait. And what it's going to do, it's going to basically rub him the wrong way. Imagine two guys going at it. Aggression. Who eases that conversation? The women, come on, the ladies that be in the room have to step in and they have to like rub on their babe's back and be like, babe, it's okay. You know, babe, don't take it like that. That's what kind of calms the man down. But if you're going to sit right there and go foot for foot with him with aggression, you're just going to cause yourself a whole heap of headaches, pain. There's going to be some things said that y'all wish y'all didn't say. And I truly believe that aggression and just being angry and frustrated with your partner in life and your loved ones, I believe that it kind of like, this is me putting my own two cents in now, y'all. I believe that it kind of like takes away time off your life. Nobody has time for the negativity, all right? So don't match his aggression. It's going to cause hurt, pain, headaches, regrets, health issues, like what I just mentioned. What you can do instead is, I looked up the opposite of aggression, and it's actually meekness. Meekness, which is a form of submission, believe it or not. And meekness is more calm. It's more understanding. It's kind of like on a beam. When you have meekness here and you have aggression there, if you do aggression with aggression, you're just going to stay there. But if you do meekness and to aggression, you can kind of meet in the middle and it's neutral. All right. So try that approach. I know that a lot of us ladies like to stand our ground. T is from Baltimore. I stand my ground, okay? You best believe. But in my marriage, I realized that that doesn't get me anywhere. And you think about it, when you're arguing with your significant other, nobody wins. Nobody wins but the enemy. And that's why I think being meekness isn't weak. It's called being wise. And if you want to read up on wisdom, go to Proverbs 14:1 and then holla at me about it, all right? On to the next one. Number four. Leave your superwoman cape at the door, sis. Leave your superwoman cape at the door. Why am I saying this? Because I just talked about being the independent woman and being an alpha woman, but I didn't go deep into it. I tend to be an independent woman. Not tend to be, I am. You know, I have a lot going on. Before my husband came, I'd already reached my success and all the things like that. I have a mom who is independent and I was very inspired by her. And this enabled me to be an independent woman. But let me tell you, do y'all know how tiring it is to be a strong Black Latina woman? Because they always talk about these strong Black women and strong women in the world. Y'all, it takes a lot. Let me tell you, it comes with back pains, it comes with stress, it comes with headaches. And I realized, you know what? I don't have to be the strong one all the time. That's the good thing about marriage. I don't have to be the strong one all the time. Let that man be the strong one, sis. Let him be your Superman. Let him know he a king, all right? Let him, you know, be vulnerable. You can be the alpha woman in the workplace, but leave that cape at the door. When you get in the house, go ahead and be like, babe, I love you. I miss you. I want to hug. I want to kiss. Oh, baby, I thought about you all day. Be feminine. You know, do something. However you do it. Don't be all on edge. You know, I got to do this. I got to do that. You know, making it seem like you're in charge of things in the household. You may be in charge of things in the household, sis, but you ain't got to fling it around like that. Let that man know that he is the Superman of your life, that he is the king. And by you doing this, I believe that it will charge him to know his role as the pastor of your household. That is crucial. You want your man to know that he is the pastor of the household and you are the first lady of that household, all right? That is what's most important. This also increases intimacy because it makes your hubby just want to rub up on you, all right? You're married, so talking about rubbing up on each other ain't bad. If you one of my wives in the waiting, your time is coming, sweetie, okay? Don't feel bad. Your time is coming. But yeah, that is going to make your husband want to rub up on you. Put it in your notes now so that when you marry, you'll be like, okay, let me leave my superwoman cape at the door, all right? And that is number four. Number five, all right, y'all, I'm trying to get to it. We 15 minutes in. Let's keep it going. Think before you speak. All right, think before you speak. Another one that QueenTee is working on that isn't as easy as it sounds, but something that my business partner of MSCOC taught me, she is also a licensed clinical therapist, is HALT. H-A-L-T. She taught me this a while ago. Actually, while I was dating my husband, my now husband, she taught me this. She said, don't make any decisions while you're hungry, angry, lonely, or tired. Ooh, okay. How many of y'all get in arguments because you're hungry? How many of y'all get in arguments because you're tired? I know I do. And it's not good, because when QueenTee is hungry and when QueenTee is tired, she says anything, all right? Anything and everything. So that was something that I had to work on. Not only in marriage, this is something that I had to work on while I was dating. And guess what? I'm still working on it. So think before you speak. Remind yourself of the main topic, you know, when you're in a when you're in a debate, a disagreement. I don't want to say argument, because everything isn't an argument. When you're in a disagreement or when you're in some type of debate with your spouse, always remind yourself of the main topic. Make sure that your responses address the topic, not your feelings, because we tend to get in our feelings, ladies, okay? We be alpha woman, we be independent woman, but we be in our feelings, and that's not a lie. I know I do. All right, so deep breaths help. And it's also okay to tell your or ask your significant spouse if you can reconvene the conversation in 15 minutes when you cool down. Or let them know, hey, do you mind if I take a walk? You know, is this something that we can talk about in 30 minutes? Is this something that we can try not to put it off till the next day? If you really have to put it off to the next day because maybe you have to go to work or something, okay. But I would rather you not go to sleep mad or upset at each other or just confused. You want to make sure that when you go to bed at night, that you and your spouse are in a good place. So that is number five, think before you speak. Number six, take everything to God. All right, take everything to God. So this is a big one. I don't even think I told y'all. There are seven tips, because y'all are probably like, how long is this going to go on, T? It's seven tips. We almost there. So number six is take everything to God. I believe that clarity, you should pray for God for clarity, you know, about the topic that maybe you felt uneasy about. Maybe during like your 30-minute, 2-hour break until y'all reconvene, go to God just to get clarity about the topic. Go to God to get clarity about your feelings, about, you know, is what I'm feeling, like, is it rational? Is it irrational? These are things you gotta ask, because the enemy will come and feed things into your mind. Your significant other may bring up a topic and it might make you feel uneasy, and you might take it in a way that they didn't even intend for you to take it. So this is why I say take everything to God. Pray against rebellion. This is something I got from Bishop T.D. Jakes. Praying against rebellion, because there is a rebellious spirit that lies around just waiting for opportunities to get you to get in a disagreement with your spouse. And that is something that we just don't want, okay? So pray against rebellion, forgiveness of self and forgiveness of your significant other, because sometimes, let me tell you, when I be in prayer with God, I be complaining. And yes, I do have this on here. You want to pray more for your hubby, pray more for blessings for your hubby than you complain. And a lot of people say, oh, don't go to God with your complaints. And I'm gonna just tell y'all, whoever said that, I don't know why they said it, but I feel like you should be real with God. If it's something that you're thinking about and something that's on your mind and your heart, he already knows it's there. So why not bring it up? But I think you should refute it by actually, use a rebuttal. I'm sorry, y'all. By actually like praying for blessings. Like after you complain, you know, every complaint lift up a blessing or some type of love to your husband, you know, something just so it can be evenly balanced. You don't want to give the enemy anything to play with. I'm telling y'all, any and everything. He uses any and everything to kill, steal, and destroy. It's in the word. Like, it's so true. It's scary. But you have to just know what weapons you have. And your weapons are the word of God, your time with God, and the words, the affirmations that you're pouring into your marriage. That is how you fight, all right? So use discernment. Use this when tempting thoughts come to your mind. I said that rebellious spirit will come. Something will feed into your mind, and you'll think that for some reason your husband is against you and not with you, and it'll just stir up drama that just doesn't need to be there. So that's why I'm saying pray to God about everything. Take everything to him. Leave nothing off the table. Bring him everything. Even if it's the smallest thing and you're like, I don't think it's a big deal. It's a big deal because it came to your mind. All right. Sorry, I got a little bit like, I really got into that one, y'all, because like the enemy be trying it. And I'm so grateful that the Lord put that one on my heart to write down. Last but not least, remember the mission always, period. All right. Remember the mission always. I should put exclamation point, not period. But period just sound better. Anyway, 7, remember the mission always. Be committed to the mission, you know, because submission goes both ways, all right? Being committed to the mission is both commitment to God and your husband. Submission goes both ways, can be done in several ways, but serves one mission. What mission is that? God's mission. It's not your husband's mission. It's not your mission. It's God's mission that we're serving. Okay. So a lot of people look at submission as, I don't want to, you know, bow to him. It's not about him, sis. It's not about you. It's about Jesus. It's about God. Remember who it's about. Remember the mission. All right. Ephesians 5:21. Remember the mission. All right. The mission is that you submit to one another out of reverence to God. You don't submit to one another because you want your husband, you know, you want God to know that you love your husband and you're so, that's not what it's about. The mission is about submitting to God no matter what. All right, sis? And knowing your why saves you. This, I have to read this because it's like it's on here and I look down and I want to get it right. Knowing your why saves you at times things get stressful and confusing. An example that you know to know, remember your why, something you can do is you can say, here's an example. I don't feel like giving him a kiss because I really can't stand him right now, but I love him, or but, you know, God would want me to, you know, but this is about serving God's mission, not about how I feel right now. So, you know, in a shorter version, you can say something like, I don't feel like ... but I'll do it because, you know, things like that. Remember, this ain't about you. This ain't about your hubby. This is about God's mission. So let me go over these 7 really quick. Girls, I'm so happy I got that done in less than 30 minutes because I thought I was going to keep y'all here forever. All right. So 1 is be a partner. And to sum that up, this is going to help you build trust and team building, teammanship with your husband. All right. 2, it strengthens communication, which is keep your advice to yourself, sis. All right. Keep your advice to yourself. Strengthen that communication by being supportive and by being loving. And if you really feel like your advice is needed, let him try his approach first. If his approach doesn't work, then introduce your approach, all right? But I also say this, go to 6, which we're gonna get to. Take everything to God. Take your advice to God, because if God really wanted it to go your way, your husband would have asked you, what should I do? All right. So think about it that way. 3, don't match his aggression. And this reduces arguments and it shortens the post-recovery time. You know what that means, wives? It means it's going to be fun time. All right. Makeup time. All right. Yes. You want that. You want the enemy to know that you can't stop my marriage. Like, we still gonna have a party in our bedroom, all right? I don't know what y'all call it, party time. Let me just move on before I say some things I don't need to say up on here, all right? Number four is leave your superwoman cape at the door. This builds femininity, and we're talking about femininity a lot now. It's something that's been very foreign to Queen T. Again, Queen T is more of an independent alpha woman, but being feminine is something that I'm learning to embrace. There's a new woman in me that I never knew was there. And I'm telling you, she's there in you. You just have to allow her to kind of take over things, all right? Especially in your home. You can be the alpha woman at home, but allow yourself to kind of move in a position where you're not afraid to be vulnerable when it comes to being with your husband. And you're not afraid to allow him to take the lead on things, all right? If God allowed you to marry this person, you're going to be completely fine. He ain't going to burn house down, sis. He a grown man. He been living his whole life by himself, you know, and you know, vice versa. We just always think that our way is the best way, and you know, we made it, but he's still here too, so we made it, sis. All right, number five, think before you speak. This avoids so much. I talked about it. It makes sure that, look, it avoids so much. You don't need the stress. You don't need the drama. Think before you speak. You just don't want to say anything that you can't take back. You don't want to do anything that was said. You know, you don't want to be enabled to do something from something that he said, you know, as a rebuttal to what you said. Just, it avoids so much, point blank. Number six, take everything to God. This builds your faith and it protects your marriage. This is how you fight for your marriage. Take everything to God. Leave nothing off the table. Take everything. Everything. Let's say it like that. And last but not least, remember the mission always. It's bigger than you. It ain't about you, sis. All right? It's bigger than you. It's not your husband's mission. It's not God's. It is God's mission. I take that back. It's not your husband's mission. It's not your mission. It's God's mission. All right? And on that note, ladies, I'm going to close this out. Maybe the S word is going to come up, but I'm so proud of us that we got through this topic, because let me tell you, I've been holding off doing this topic for a while, but I think that this is the perfect time. We're going into a new year, and these practical tips will help you start the new year off right. This is, you know, they say new year, new you, but no. This is the new you with God by your side, all right? This is the new you with God by your side. Can't nothing go wrong, whether you're married, whether you're about to be married, or whether you're a wife in the waiting. These practical tips, if you practice them now, even while you're dating, you know, you will learn another side of you that you'll realize that I can do this and God is preparing me for where he's taking me, all right? We are praying for kingdom marriages and nothing less. All right, ladies, this is the Fiancé Coach connecting you to your true wife goals. Let's roll. Until next time.